Well, look what's back in the garage again. So, I had these washers behind the lug nuts like this to bring the wheel out because it was hitting right up in here, as you can see. And you can see what it was doing to the tire. So, previously you saw me with these wheel spacers, right? So they go on there. But the problem I'm seeing is this. You know, you want these centered. You want them centered in the rims. I had to make some modifications. Woo, that fucker's hot. Woo! So as you can see, I had to make some modifications. That just came off the grinder. I've been grinding on that for about 10 minutes. So what I had to do was I had to put this bevel on the edge. You see it's kind of curved that way. So now this will lay flat and it'll center itself perfectly in the rim like that. So I've had to shave down a lot of this edge right here. So I shaved the edge down and then I cut it back at an angle. So it self-centers. So now, you can turn it in there. So now you can see the line it made all the way around inside. See that cut line right there? So I know this is contacting everything. So when I put this wheel on, I mean, it can't sit crooked because it'll just fall right into place. So that one's done and it's perfectly centered in there now. And now I'll show you the other one, what it really looks like. See, once this goes in there, it's crooked as shit. It won't center. So I have to grind a lot of that out. So that's the issue I'm having with these. Is these are made for a wider type hub. But it's a good thing I got the thing over there, because that's what I've been doing, is grinding the piss out of it. And this is hotter than a son of a bitch. You can see the grinded edge. And then you can see the taper I put on it. Well, maybe. But there's a taper on that. They taper this way and that way. Because when I'm grinding it, I take this and I tilt it up at an angle. So I'm grinding it like this at an angle. So it'll wedge down in, because this has got an angle on it here. So since this is already angled, this angle will lay right in there perfect. So, but boy, this son of a bitch gets hot. So that's laying in there absolutely freaking perfectly perfect. I can't do any better than that. So now I gotta do this one. And I'm leaving this rim off for now because I'm gonna use this as my guide. So, back to grinding. So then that'll give me a nice, that'll give me just what I need, 12 millimeters. And that'll keep me out away from that. Oh yeah, easily. That'll easily keep me out away from that. So, yeah, I got these for $8. They're an Amazon return. So, it says in the bag, thank you for giving this part a second life. So, yeah, they don't quite fit, but for $8, I'll make them fit. So this will give me a hell of a lot more clearance than one of them little washers. So then my wheels will never hit again. So yeah, now they'll probably hit out here. I don't care, I could bend the fender up. All right, I'm gonna go grind this. And man, you can feel the heat coming right through these gloves. It's crazy, this thing is hot. But now I know how much to grind off and we'll go from there. All right, that worked pretty damn good. The wheel isn't wobbling or nothing. Perfectly straight. So, getting here with the light on. So you can see the spacer in there. Well, maybe not. You see it? No, I don't think. Oh yeah, you can. It's spinning pretty good in there. It's good enough. I mean, the tire tread has a wobble to it. But you can see the tire tread has a wiggle. They always do. There you go, now you can see it. But if you look at the rim's got no wobble to it. So there's one side down. And yeah, that's kind of nice. Now I got all kinds of freaking space in there now. Now you look up in there. Look at all that gap now. I can put my damn hand down in here now. So that ain't gonna be hitting at all anymore. So that's cool. Kind of ruined my tire a little bit, but that's why I got a spare. All right, on to the other side. All right, so now I have moved on to the second thing. I told you before I bought new rubbers because these rubbers are shot, as you can tell. They've been taking an ass kicking in here. And all these do is you just grab them and you just pull them out. So these are whipped. And they're wicked easy. You just shove them bitches in there like that. And that's it. Oops. And you let them go flying across the floor on you. So, hi puppy. Puppy's out here. So you just shove them in there, and then that's it. You just replace the rubbers. These are off a golf cart, so. And you just slide them on. I'm gonna put oil on them. This looks like a tiny bit big, so I'll just go sand this down a little tiny bit, just to make it fit in there a little snugger. I can hammer them in, but I don't wanna do that. I want them to turn a tiny bit, so I'll just sand these down a tiny bit, and that's it. So then I got the new rubbers. They're pretty close. They're really close to the same size. But as you can see, God, maybe I'll just tap them in with a hammer. And I'm gonna oil them. So I'm gonna hit them with a little bit of oil when I put them in, so. And that'll be that. They fit on here just fine, so. Man, $10. I have all new rubbers in my suspension, then I'll go back and I'll order new rubbers for up here. Because these are just the back for now. So easy stuff is, you just push this on, you take the two nuts off in that plate, and then this just slides right off like that. And that's all there is to it. So, yep, I gotta give these a quick little feather down, and I'll put a bed together. And I don't need to show you anymore because that's all there is to it. All you gotta do is put my little magic jack back here just to get the weight off the back end. And then that's it. And I've pre-drilled holes because that ain't bolted down. So I drilled a couple holes up through, you can see the light, to tell me drill behind him 1 inch to catch the beam. So, all right, I'm going to go sand these down a little bit and pop them in. Well, here we are on side two. Boy, there's nothing left of these. These bottom ones took a hell of a beating. The top ones are all split to shit. Wow. Now this one ain't too awful bad. I mean, it's a little crispy. Get another one out of there. See, it doesn't take too much to take care of your trailer, you know? So, now I'm gonna grab the other four and put them in. I'll get out here in the light better. Oh, better hurry up and shut the radio off. I can barely hear it. We don't want YouTube saying, hey, we hear a radio. Yeah, so look at these. Man, so that was riding right on the steel to steel, some of these. The suspension rubbers, I'm telling you. Usually the bottom ones take it worse than the upper ones, because you can see it. But time for new ones. Woohoo! You know what's funny is, I just took this over and buffed these up a little bit. You know, people might see my trailer and be like, hi, Minnie. Hi, puppy. Hi, Sibby. And be like, man, that trailer is a piece of shit. Stop recording for some reason.
Okay, find the bang bang. Where is it? Where's the bang bang? Find it. Find it. Smell. Smell. No, that wasn't it. That noise wasn't it. Find the bang bang. Smell. 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 Where is it? Find it. Find it. Find it. Find the bang bang.
Oh, he's right by it. Oh, he's right by it.
Where's bang bang? Smell. Where is it? Oh, he's close. He's close. Where is it? Where is it? Where's bang bang? Jeez, you look right at it. Where is it? Where's bang bang? Come on. Where is it? Where's bang bang? Where is it? Smell. You're almost there. Jesus Christ, you're right there. Where's the bang bang? Where's the bang bang? Smell it. Smell it out. Smell it. Smell. 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 You almost got it. Smell it out. So where is it? Junior, what the hell is that? What is that? Yeah, there it is. Oh, this thing's throwing off heat. Yeah, that's hot. That's probably throwing them off. All right. Jesus Christ. I don't know how long I've been recording for, but that's enough of that. All right, everybody. That's enough for me today. I got to grind these rubbers, put them in, and I'm done. Have a good one. Like, share, subscribe. And what in the hell is my floor all wet right here? What the hell is that? Ooh, shit. Is that acid? Ooh, this is all wet right here. What the hell is dripping out of this thing? Where's that coming from? Uh-oh. Oh, it's hot. Okay. Get away from the battery. I got to put a block in that. Tip it back the other way. Son of a bitch. Look out, buddy. Why don't you go back inside? I gotta get a block of wood underneath this. I don't need that. I don't know why that's dripping out. Where the hell is that coming from? No, no, no. Stay back. This must have a crack in the case. The rope's all wet. And it's all wet right in there. Mother flipping bone smacker. I think the case might be cracked. Well, you know what that means now. That means I gotta get this damn thing. Oh my God. Come on, go outside. Go back outside. All right. Let's see how bad the battery acid is now. Fuck, I'm almost out of this stuff. Baking soda. Damn it. Come on, phone. Ooh. Neutralize that shit. That's definitely acid. God damn it. Baking soda bubble right up. All right, go outside. I gotta go inside and get some more baking soda. All right, everybody, I'll catch you later. I gotta hurry up and get this acid off of carpet. Have a good one. Well, I'm sad to say these are all shot. They say 12 volts, but it says recharge and retest. For some reason, this started, acid was coming out of here. And I put baking soda on to kind of clean it up. But that's no good. That says 11.63 volts, charge, retest. That's a piece of crap. That's a piece of crap. This says 8.52 volts. That's a piece of crap. This one says it's possibly okay, and that's a real piece of crap. So, welcome to $8,000 of pieces of crap. Thank God I got them for free. So now these are all scrap weight. They're not any good. So when I get more time tomorrow, I'm going to test all of my batteries over here. I'll be testing all these one by one. I'll just take off one lead and just check each battery one by one. You know, they look white like that because baking soda. Yep. Unbelievable. Well, I didn't know. You know what I mean? I didn't know if these were any good. I tried reviving them. It ain't going to work. There's not holding them. They're shit. So, all right. I just ground down my rubber things here. I'm going to put this together. And I'm going in the house. And again, have a good one.